He's doing comedy in town out in Wasilla tomorrow, or actually Wasilla tonight at Everett's, and then Coots tomorrow. Details at hookedentertainment.com. I've had issues with this guy before, unfortunately. Had to kick him out of the studio many, many years ago. Comedian Gino Bisconte.
Hey, buddy, I've been in a timeout for 7 years, thanks to you.
Yes. I did another morning show back in the day at another station here in town, and we had to kick you out of the studio for some inappropriate material.
Oh, you know, inappropriate, because we live in the most racist country in the world.
Yeah, that's true. Yeah, that's true.
And whenever, well, let me tell you, I live in New York City where, you know, like me and you are the white devil. We're terrible human beings. And whenever someone says that I want to choke them for their own good like your parents would do and be like, do you realize every day 80% of the world wakes up every day and they live in India or China. So the fact that you wake up every day in America, you've won the lottery to begin with. Okay?
Yes, you win.
You win. They're like, no, it's right. But then, and I don't want to be like, then leave. But okay, then why don't you just take a vacation to another country for a week and pretend to live there? Oh, young lady, leave your clitoris at the duty free. You're not allowed to take that with you to a lot of. They just don't get how lucky we are to be in this country.
Can you use the C word on radio? Is that a...
That's a medical term.
Okay, that is a medical term.
It
okay.
really is. Okay. It really is. Okay. I'm having one inserted this week.
Nice. Hey, congratulations. How have things changed in comedy for you? I mean, I know things with hypersensitivity. Obviously, things have become so political with, you know, I mean, the COVID virus and everything going on. Has comedy changed for you at all in how you write and how you prepare?
Brad, no. And let me tell you something. It's so good to be back. Like, I walked in, because I used to do Coots on a week run every year around February. I walked into Coots last night, and I just was toasting. It was so good to be home, because you know I love coming here. And in the past like 7 years, I haven't changed a bit in what I'm saying, but because I'm not smart enough. Like I used to I'm not, like, I just like telling my stupid third grade jokes, you know what I mean?
This is what, well, it's your style. It's what you do.
It's my,
you're
brand.
Not Jim Gaffigan, you're not Andrew Dice Clay.
No.
Gina Bisconte, this is my comedy.
And I used to say, and it's so easy with the gift of hindsight, like last month March was 20 years I lived in New York. I lived there longer than anywhere. And like when you first get up to New York, you're like all right, I'm gonna everyone, it's like 2001. I'm like, I'm going to work on my set. I'm going to get seen. I'm going to get an agent. I'm going to get a festival. I'm going to get late night. I'm going to get a TV show. That's the game, right?
Yeah.
But I could never clean up my act or whatever, or change what I said, or be, I don't even want to say likable, because I think I'm a charming a-hole when I'm on stage. I really
am.
But
be somebody who you're not.
Yeah.
And fake it to be able to write on a show or be on a show or something like that.
And watch me make it sound deep, but it's not. Somebody said this to me years ago, and it registers now. The Buddha. And trust me, I'm tying this into my third grade humor. If you don't go within, you go without. Let me explain what that means now to me, and I get it. And so many comics go without. I go within. I say what I want to say, and it goes out there. Okay? And now, thanks to the way the comedy world has fragmented over the past decade between YouTube and social media.
Yeah.
And what I was just showing you, I'm on a thing called Compound Media. I have a show called In Hot Water that it's not a podcast. It's like a podcast if you listen, but it's done in the studio with my dear friend Aaron Berg. We do it 4 days a week. Subscribe to compoundmedia.com and see me, see the boss's flagship show, Anthony from Opie and Anthony.
Subscribe, does that mean I have to pay?
It's behind a paywall, which is great, so we can say whatever we want. It's like a cover charge.
And it's so much great programming.
You get more than 4 days a week. It's like a dirty, you know, it's like the Today Show with the F-bomb. So I just create. And suddenly, saying whatever I wanted, I'm not going to be rich and famous, but there's a platform of devoted fans, which is all you need now. You need 1,000 or 100,000 people that follow you on social media, and they will supply your brand. We do merch. We do everything, and they're your loyal followers.
Oh, wow.
And they're so easy to please because they think like you think. They like what you like, and there's no middle ground. I've always said this. It's like there's no middle ground with me. People are either like, that Gino's hilarious, or that Gino's an a-hole. He's an idiot. But do you think I'm going to sit there being like, let me see if I can sway them over? But that's what going within got me, just staying on my brand, and I enjoy everything I'm doing. Okay.
Yeah, it's certainly a different world, and you keeping it the way you're doing is pretty amazing. We're talking with comedian Gino Bisconte. Gino, we gotta take a break, but I would like to talk a little bit more about how the pandemic and talk about a little bit about your comedy and what people can see tonight and tomorrow night. Details hookedentertainment.com for the tonight show at Everett's in Wasilla, and then at Coots coming up tomorrow. Tickets, details, hookedentertainment.com. gino.com. And Gino, we're talking about, you know, COVID and changed a lot of lives and things like that. What has it changed for you when it come to doing shows, especially, you know, when you're in New York City?
I was doing a cigar show, and it was a place called, shout out to my buddy Soul Joe Royersford. He's another one, I always say, boots on the ground, because there's so many people like, we're going to keep comedy going, whatever it takes.
Yeah.
And he set up a giant tent, looks like an airplane hangar, with those giant space heaters. And he had comics like Wayans, Dice Clay. So he does this cigar tasting on a Wednesday night, and it just turns cold real fast. And it's me, my buddy Chris Monty, and my buddy Bobby. And it's 25 people freezing all of a sudden. They paid $80 to watch three comedians have one cigar and taste whiskey. And this answers your question, but hopefully it was worth the ride, people. I look at them like, I'm like, comedy's back. I said, let me tell you guys something. I said, let me ask you this. I said, if 1 year ago someone had said to you, do you want to spend, you see where this is going, yes, bro? Absolutely. You want to spend $80 to watch, to freeze your ass up in a tent with heaters watching a guy tell third grade jokes and have a cigar and a whiskey, you would hang up the phone and say that. But I'm like, you didn't, you came out there, and they were rabid. And that's why it's better than ever now. And that's why, look, I'd be amazed if anyone came out to a comedy show now, like after it was taken from them. Laughter heals you more than anything. It's a fact now.
The endorphins that it gives off and everything. Yeah.
I don't know why you always throw me out of your show when we think completely alike. But I say literally that word. I'm like, it releases endorphins. It relieves stress.
All right. So we're going to relieve some stress tonight at Everett's. Two shows, 7 and 9:30. And then at Coots tomorrow, 7 and 9:30, hookedentertainment.com. People that haven't seen you or know your comedy, what are they going to see tonight and tomorrow night?
Facts in the easiest digestible form. Stuff that a third grader will look at you and be like, huh? This guy gets it. That's it. It's just me like talking about just why it's important to laugh, making fun of COVID, making fun of people that take themselves too seriously. That's what it's always been. I do jokes about race and religion because I was raised to just, thank God I was raised in a Norman Rockwell painting where you were just thankful for everything on a farm in South Jersey where, you know, like, we were Italian, we were all the minorities, you know? And that's why, like, anyone that sits there and preaches I'm not a racist, they've got something to hide. Like, people that joke with everyone else about their race, religion, and color, which I don't know if you know this, in America, it's like that because we let everyone in. We let everyone in. We're so lucky to live here. It's such a blessing to have all these races, religions, adjectives. And if you can't enjoy them by joking around with them, I don't see what you're doing.
Gino Pasconti going to be at Everett's tonight, 7 and 9:30.
That was good coffee. I don't care what anyone says.
You know, I made it myself.
4 days ago, yes, Brett!
4 days ago. It's like wine. I like it to, you know, chill or whatever.
My mother would do that. She'd sit there, she'd come home from work, and the coffee was like 12 hours old. She'd pour it, my aunt would be like, what are you doing? I'm having a coffee.
Exactly. Don't mind the mold on top. It's
good for you.
Yeah, it's good for it. It's penicillin. And do you have a website?
Gino, everything is GinoBasconti.com, except my Twitter, because I've been banned a couple times. Well, I was banned.
No.
I was banned once, but then once you're banned, you become Anne Frank, and you're constantly hiding. It's Diamond Eugene One, the person that runs it. But if you Google comedian Gino Bisconti, trust me, we did this once. You can, if you Google,
there's oodles of stuff.
Thank you. Yes. Somebody, like, try and spell it wrong. They spelled it Ginovik, and they're like, this idiot. Because there's nothing close.
That's awesome.
But it does say, are you sure you mean comedian? Which is hurtful, Google. It's hurtful.
That is hurtful. Well, thank you for being on the show.
Always a great time. You know that, Brad.
When you run out of cool things to say,